Al-Kufr versus Al-Shirk. Both are disbelief. In Al-Shirk, it is setting partners to Allah in worship. And every shirk is kufr, is disbelief. Every shirk is kufr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about those who have taken Jesus, the son of Mary, as God besides Allah or his mother, he said, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. He called them kuffar. Can you imagine that many Muslims and many leaders of Islamic centers and many PhD holders who are involved in interfaith dialogue, they say, you can't call them kuffar. Well, say that to Allah. Argue with Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةٌ. Indeed, those who said Allah is one in three or three in one out of three are kuffar. Answer Allah, don't talk to me. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. Those who said, Al-Masih, Isa ibn Maryam, is Allah, or the son of Allah, are kuffar. You know what? You only have one option, to erase these verses from the Quran. Like the Christians, when I asked the priest about some verses which are terrible in the Bible, we said, well, we don't believe in these segments anymore. Khalas. We edited the Bible and we don't believe in this word of God anymore. Can you do this with the Quran? No. Non-Muslims perceive Muslims as what? As kuffar. Not only as kuffar, as terrorists too. Even though we're being killed and murdered and targeted everywhere, but we're accused falsely of being the killers and the oppressors. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in Surah An-Nisa, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَٰلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. So, al-shirk leads to an-nar. Al-kufr leads to an-nar eternally. في حديث معاذ بن جبل, may Allah be pleased with him, and the hadith is a sound hadith collected by Imam al-Bukhari. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to معاذ بن جبل, أَفَلَا أُبَشِّرُكَ, shall I not give you some good news? He said, certainly, Ya Rasulullah. He said, من مات لا يشرك بالله شيئا حرم الله جسده على النار. Subhanallah, the question is also in line with the story which we all started. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Mu'adh ibn Jabal, that whoever dies in a state of monotheism, dies while not setting partners to Allah in worship. Believe me, brothers and sisters, there are some who say La ilaha illallah, but they don't know what it means. And they may sit partners to Allah in worship. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to one of his companions, who said, Ma sha Allah wa shi'it. He said a very simple word. He said, if Allah wills and you will. He said, Aj'altani lillahi nidda. Have you taken me as a partner to Allah? He equated me to Allah. How could you say so? You should put Allah number one. Then if you want to say whoever's name, you say then. Thumma. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam blocked all the means of shirk, which is known as saddu al-dhara'i'. Saddu al-dhara'i'. So, shirk or kufr both lead to eternal abode in the far of hell, wal-iyadu billah, which is setting partners to Allah in worship or denying entirely the presence of Allah or believing in God but denying His oneness or believing in God but denying His right upon us, which is to be worshipped. So the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Mu'adh ibn Jabal, whoever dies while not setting partners to Allah in worship, Allah will forbid the fire of hell from touching his flesh. He said, shall I not tell people? He said, lest they rely on that and then do anything else. So inshallah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to ponder in this ayah, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Imran,
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Or you who believe, you should fear Allah and keep your duty to Him as it should be, and die not, but as Muslims. May Allah make us amongst them.